National light middleweight title, 12 3-minute rounds is the journey. The maths that really matter for our main event, and Anthony Mundine, the older of the two fighters by 2 years. On the scales 24 hours ago, 0.1 of a kilo only separated. We'll talk about real weight, actual weight in ring as the fight progresses. Mundine with a 7-centimetre height advantage, both 178 on the reach. Main event time coming your way. Let's go centre ring to Mr. Benny Damon.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Newcastle Entertainment Centre, it is time for main event boxing. Let's get them out. Firstly, to the red corner, Joshua Clotty. Please welcome to the blue corner, Anthony Mundine. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is 12 3-minute rounds for the WBA's International Light Middleweight title. Your judges, Pat O'Connor, Justin Kennedy, and Alex Fraser. And the referee is Anthony Shipley. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the evening. Introducing firstly the red corner. He wears black trunks with red trim and weighed in 69.7 kilograms. Hailing from Ghana, he has a professional record of 42 fights, 37 wins with 22 knockouts, a former world champion, Joshua Grandmaster Clotty. And in the blue corner, he wears light blue trunks and weighed in 69.8 kilograms. With a professional record, 51 fights, 46 wins and 27 knockouts. He fights out of Redfern, New South Wales, and is trained by his father, the great Tony Mundine. He's a three-time world champion, Anthony the Man Mundine.
Time for talking. It is now over. It's fight time. Anthony weighed in at 69.8 kilos. That is probably a 74 or 75 kilogram frame centering now.
Okay, let's listen to me. I want a good clean bout. Obey my instructions at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. Okay, keep your head classes out of it and low blows. Good luck. Touch them up.
Anthony Shipley, referee, judges Pat O'Connor, Justin Kennedy, Alex Fraser. But ultimately now it is down to two. Two only determine who walks away with their head held high and who has some serious questions about their immediate future. On Main Event Boxing, live around Australia, it is Main Event time. 12 rounds for the WBA International Light Middleweight title, and for one big run, it is Anthony the Man Mundine and Josh Clottie. We are under 69.85 kilos. Clottie in the black and red, Mundine in the blue and red. First thing we notice about Anthony Mundine, gone are the boxing boots, and he is wearing the lightweight Nike sneakers. From memory, the first time I can remember seeing Anthony.
Yeah, maybe he wants to do some running around the ring.
Two right-handers. Mundine with a height and reach advantage. Naturally, the bigger of the two.
Looking at Clottie's physique, he's obviously done his homework. He looks very fit.
He looks in super condition. And, you know, very confident demeanor about him. And, you know, they're definitely here to win.
Yes.
Ghanaians. And same with Anthony the Man Mundine. So we're going to have a very interesting contest here, I think.
Looked very evenly matched early on.
Mundine so fast with the left hand early in the fight.
Thought he'd be more, you know, on side on using, snapping his jab in this first round, or in these most of the rounds, to be honest. Good body shot from Clottie there. Very good body shot.
And a nice left hook to follow.
Tries to come over the top, Clottie. Right to the belly button, if you like. Mundine comes over the top with the right hand. This is Anthony's fifth time only at junior middleweight. Put nine times as a middleweight.
Clottie looking very strong to me.
Certainly doubling up on the left hand there.
He's putting them together beautifully.
Yes.
He's no stranger to the big stage, as Anthony complains about a low shot.
He's body punching well, Clottie.
To get on the inside.
Oh. Referee Anthony Shipley caught one, I think.
And yeah, we've got some feeling. It's only taken 2 minutes. They're a pretty clear indicator of how much this means, how much is on the line.
It's a high-energy contest. Clottie looking for the haymaker there.
Blowing up that he was hit on the back of the head. Referee didn't see anything. Says, fight on. Last couple of seconds of what has been truly intriguing opening round. Oh, that wasn't low, was it?
It was a little bit low.
Borderline, perhaps. Wow. Left hook. But look, a big round, I think, by both fighters. But Clottie's landed the heavier shots, I think.
Very close round.
We're going to fight.
We do.
Our blue corner fighters tonight using books of protocol. And the results show for themselves on sale tonight here.
Don't worry about it, just keep on that one hook. He's turning like that.
All seconds down and out.
Round number two. Have you changed your tips wherever you're sitting?
Mundine needs to get his jab working. Where's the snapping jab?
Clocked his corner, telling him to stick to the body and then over the top with the right hand to the head. So let's see if he follows that advice.
Get him up. Not the first game plan of the like against Anthony Mundine. Ripped to the body and try and drop his left elbow. Got him underneath the elbow into the ribcage there, did Clotty.
Got him good.
Hard to believe this is Anthony's 52nd professional bout. We all remember him debuting back in 2000. He's done it 51 times since.
Incredible. Clotty body punching beautifully and left double left hooking really well, winning this round so far.
And already more competitive than the Mosley fight.
Oh, without doubt. No comparison.
Clotty,
good jab.
He's really here to win, isn't he?
He's fighting for everything.
Had Mundine on the end of the jab there. Josh Clotty doubles up the left hand again. Very compact in what he does. Very successful thus far, Josh Clotty. Mundine gained an awkward-looking punch with the right hand into the rib cage,
and that's where the experience is taken over here. Clotty just had that ring experience with the high caliber of athletes. Nice uppercut from Clotty.
There's that lovely uppercut. He's got a ripper uppercut, Clotty.
Mundine tries changing angles. Both guys have got literally a full kit of punches. Anthony, a better record in his last 10 fights. He's 8 wins, 2 losses. Clotty, 7 wins, 3 losses.
He's pushing the action, Clotty. Oh, right hand, left hook. Right hand was rolled off the shoulder, but the left hook landed. And a bit of healing with the glove there from Clotty. He knows every trick.
Even though he's a smaller man, he looks like he's bullying Mundine a little bit.
Yes, he is.
He's wearing the shots very well, Josh Clotty.
He is.
And seeing them even earlier.
As we know, he's never been stopped. At this stage, Mundine not getting through cleanly.
No one anticipated this.
Yeah, box.
Mundine, he stopped. Effectively, that's what the record books say. Stop Shane Mosley. He hadn't been stopped previously prior to.
Step back, step back.
Same applies here for Josh Clotty.
Look at the pressure he's putting on. Those body shots.
He's got no fear at all, Joshua Clotty, in this fight.
Left hook the head, left rip the body.
I also think Josh Clotty is happy to fight. He'll box, but I also think he's prepared to fight.
Oh, he's really prepared to fight.
That's a warning.
That was terrible.
That's a warning.
Good threat from Anthony.
That's a warning, mate.
Yeah. You turn back.
Apologies there at the end of the round. Good sportsmanship from both fellas. Getting a little heated center ring. Touch of class.
I mean, Clotty is pushing the action all the way through, a left hook and a right hand there. The left hook just missed, actually. But the trend of the fight, with Clotty pushing him back, working the body hard, Barry.
Beautiful, lovely clean uppercut there, but some ripper body shots he landed. Had to give Clotty that round.
Definitely.
Oh. Now, they were right behind the head, weren't they?
Terrible.
Yep.
4 seconds down and out. Round number two.
A lot of instructions being barked in both corners.
Right, they're not going to put up with this. Let's keep it clean and fight properly. Let's go.
Yeah, they touch them up. Happy to keep it clean. Fight properly. They are the instructions from Anthony Shipley.
Andy, I'm still surprised that Clotty went down. You know, even though they were illegal blows, I'm surprised that he went down to his knees. But Mundine coming out and throwing bombs at the start of round three.
Yeah, he's trying to get the advantage. He's trying to step up.
Clotty's sneaking through with the left hand.
Love
and Mundine back against the ropes. Now, Anthony Mundine counters on the way out.
Clotty's fighting the right fight, getting right up close on Mundine.
Giving him, nice left hook.
Lovely left hook. Clotty again with the Australian back against the ropes. Oh.
I don't know if Mundine lost his footing or if he actually staggered there.
Yeah, I think he lost his footing, but it was a clean left hook.
It was very clean.
Good shot to Clotty.
Now Clotty again, closing the distance, looking for that lead uppercut with Mundine back to the ropes. So many times over his decorated career, we have seen Anthony Mundine fight successfully and offensively from his heels.
You know what's evident? Mundine's jab, which is normally a fight winner for him, it's not working.
But Clotty is offsetting him and he's being very aggressive in his attack.
And his body shots are going to take their toll, I'm telling you. Those body shots are vicious.
That's what this corner's been telling him.
Anthony's swollen above the left eye. Clotty again launches himself. Every bit of himself he is throwing into Anthony Mundine.
This is Clotty's springboard back to a world title and is not leaving anything to chance.
When he jumps in, Clotty looks like he's launching from a springboard as Mundine attacks the body viciously.
Mundine's not hurting him, though. I mean, no one's ever hurt him, really.
True. Oh, he's going for the bleachers there.
Nice work from Joshua Clotty, who has showed no emotion from the opening bell.
Lovely clean shot. Vicious left rips. He's landing that left rip consistently.
Right, let's keep him up, all right?
No, I don't think that was low.
No, I concur. Chock doubling up the left hand. Looking for a little bit of distance. Looking to reset here, Anthony Mundine. Throws lead right.
What a great fight. It looks like Clotty, the smaller man, is just stalking Mundine.
He is. He's just putting that much pressure on him.
Mundine's fighting on the
top. Oh! Anthony Mundine down! But not out! The count is on.
Seven.
And the man is to his feet, but in some trouble.
Beautiful clean shot.
And the bell sounds.
Wow.
Round number three, a huge round.
Amazing.
For Josh Clotty as the boxing world shuffles forward on their seats.
Are we seeing the demise of the man?
Water. Yes, take it off. Take it off. Do it. That's all right, it's just a flat.
Look at this for action. Clotty's been pressing him the whole fight, throwing monster shots there, caught him with the uppercut and the straight jab.
And his body shots have been exceptional. Clotty's body shots. And that look, lovely clean left hook. He was shaken there, I think.
Yep.
Even though he was off balance perhaps, but he was shaken.
And here comes the knockdown. Boom, straight down the pipe.
What a counter.
Beautiful.
4 seconds down and out.
Anthony Mundine has said, I want to fight the best. And he's been raising the bar each fight.
True.
And the bar has now been raised to former IBF welterweight world champion Josh Clotty.
Anthony
is in the fight of his life.
He certainly is. And if he comes back from here, it'll be exceptional. But honestly, I think it's going to be unlikely.
He walked onto that Clotty right hand.
And I think you'll see it again.
Well, Mundine needs to change the tone of the fight. It's been Clotty pressing the action, looking for the stoppage, working the body, coming back to the head, and his strategy has been fantastic. Anthony's got to get off those ropes.
Yeah, Mundine gets tagged with a left hook again. Clotty is
close. I can't
so
see,
quick.
I can't see any way he can turn the fight around. He just hasn't got it at the moment. He's getting whacked around the body heavily. I think it's just a matter of time from here. Ted, what do you think?
Well, boxing is a game of, you know, everything can change in one punch, and Mundy has got speed and punch power, so it can be turned around, but if the tone stays the same, it's all Joshua Clottie.
Dunn with a right hand, Clottie with an uppercut. Anthony looks quizzically at the referee. Ted from the back foot, and again a right hand.
Just grazed his chin, just grazed the chin of Mundy.
Halfway through round number four, round number three, Anthony Mundine down.
Down hard.
Rocked and then down. He looks clear. He's got his feet beneath him. I think he's, at this stage it appears Anthony has recovered well from that right hand from Josh Clottie.
He's got to reset himself, Anthony Mundine, and change the tone. That was low.
That was low. Anthony Mundine didn't balk, didn't protest, just fights on. Two uppercuts. Right on the button.
Oh, Mundine looks in trouble.
And he's lost a shoe.
Let's go, hurry up.
I've never seen that in all my years in boxing.
I think they're going to take their time to put it back on.
Yeah, there should be no hurry here. New footwear for Anthony Mundine.
Maybe he should change back.
I've never ever seen that in all my years in boxing.
33 seconds remain in round number four.
Sensational contest.
Nice from Mundine. A lead right. Anthony's speed. He has been hoping that's the deciding factor. Many thought it would be his size.
Joshua Clottie's really done his homework, hasn't he? His face, he's just got such a look of confidence.
He's supremely confident at the moment. Why wouldn't he be?
Everything, mostly, going Clottie's way. After four rounds here to the body. Left hand body, changing levels, going high. A smile and back to the corner. Time to listen in.
Scott has just been working relentlessly, and here's another example going through the fourth round. Replays. Mundine lost his footing and then later lost his shoe. There you go. Plenty of support here from the Ghanaians.
Plenty of support for Josh Clottie here, but he's from the away dressing room. The home dressing room sitting stunned. So too its supporters.
Anthony, that's what he needs to do. Move and jab. Get the jab working.
And that's when he's at his best.
That's what he needs to do. Just don't stand there with him. He's going back to the ropes. He's getting caught.
He's got to reset himself.
Clottie pushing forward, trying to almost ricochet Mundine off the ropes. Round five of a scheduled 12-round affair. Right-hand strike from Mundine. Trying to go around the gloves of Josh Clottie. He's not having a great deal of luck going through them, so looks to go around them. Nice upper body strength there, and defense from Anthony. Tries to mirror what Clottie does. Driving left hand to the sternum.
Looking at this kind of fight, it just puts into perspective how good Pacquiao is. Them elite fighters are very good.
Then with the right hand up high, Clottie again launching his attack initially towards the body.
Keep it clean, lads, keep it clean.
Halfway through round number five.
Better round for Mundine, he's used the jab a lot more. Got a tape coming up.
Loose tape on Josh Clottie, who amazingly debuted all the way back in 2005. He did so at 63 odd kilos, and all these years later, is just 69-7. A blown up welterweight fighting a junior middleweight tonight.
Far better round for Monday. He's used the jab a lot better this round.
Albeit, Clotty has not looked in danger at all.
No. Ted, you're talking about a man who's never been knocked out by any of the great fighters.
Even close, that's true.
Been on the end of a left uppercut there. Trying to keep it at distance for this time.
I guess this goes back to the old saying, you better be careful what you wish for.
Looking for that repeat left uppercut. Matt Bennett from Anthony Mundine.
This is his best round by a long shot. He's starting to put his punches together, get behind his jab. Got to use that jab a lot more. Keep him off.
Body's come here to rough up Anthony.
That's true. That's his tactic, Andy. He really has just come to pressure him and push him back.
And it's been working beautifully for him.
Last couple of seconds of the round. Mundine doubling up with the left hand before going back to his corner to reassess with Father Tony, the multi-time national champion. A huge test of not only talent but character, of makeup. That is where we are headed as round number six starts.
Anthony Mundine needs to sustain what he did in the last round. Move, use the jab, tie him up in close.
Absolutely. He needs a few of those rounds to get the mental confidence back.
Yep. Good jab.
Yeah, nice work there. Opening 30 seconds of round number six. It is Clotty in that centre ring position. And since the knockdown, Anthony looks the better man. A slip has been ruled here, and rightfully so. It wasn't a knockdown.
Just pushed him down.
Pulled him off balance. He did it quite easily, too.
Yeah, he did. Clotty wasn't happy with that by the look on his face.
Body closing the gap here. Had a couple of options, decided against all of them as the fast hands fly.
Yeah.
Get him up. That's it. Come on. Last warning on that. All right. For low blows.
Last warning for low blows there. Anthony did not even flinch, didn't protest either. Strikes with the right. Body changing.
Oh, nice combination.
That's where he's been successful. Halfway through the sixth. Mundine back against the ropes, and this is where Clotty launches.
It's where he's dangerous.
Yeah, he's got to get off the ropes and stay off them.
He does.
And this is now Anthony fighting for ring position. He's got the middle and he doesn't want to let it go.
He's fighting for survival as well. I'm surprised how easily Clotty's going off his feet.
Yes. Maybe he's starting to feel the pace a little.
He's still pushing the action though, isn't he? Landed a nice right hand there.
Chopping right hand over the top.
Final minute of the sixth. Clotty with a left hand.
Mundine and he's staggered.
Mundine
he's staggered.
Is down right up the top. Again. Second time down. Round number six. And Josh Clotty is in control.
Eight.
Wow, he got up at nine.
Anthony Mundine answers the count for the second time. He is bleeding from the left eye.
Clot is relentless. Look at this. He's not giving up. He's firing for his life here.
Dean is unsteady and is copping a high.
That's
down
it.
Again.
The referee's going to stop
Anthony
this.
Anthony Mundine.
He's unsteady on his feet.
6, 7, 8, you're right.
Down twice in the round, but the round does not have much longer.
This is close to the end.
Clotty looking to finish it. He can right here with another knockdown. Saved by the bell, perhaps.
Wow.
But for how much longer? An amazing round, gentlemen.
Power punches. Look at that beautiful uppercut to put Mundine down. I mean, Mundine did well to get up, to be fair. Clotty is relentless.
Left hook to the temple and that little right uppercut. How beautiful was that?
Relentless.
That was spot on.
Barry Moore, the temple shot than the uppercut?
Oh, I think a combination. Think look, see that?
Definitely. Accumulation of punches there.
Look like, you know, seriously showing.
4 seconds down. Showing. This is round number 7.
Heaps of hard Anthony Mundine, but wow. I tell you what, he's in serious trouble.
He's in a load of trouble.
Here we go again. Anthony Mundine, Josh Clotty, the man, 3 times down in the opening 18 minutes. How much more has he got? How much more can he give at 38 years of age?
Clotty's looking for the kill. He's pushing him.
And Clotty has powered up. Early moments, round number 7.
He's like a freight train.
He certainly is. He's like a mini Joe Frazier. Relentless.
Clotty is just walking through Mundine's punches now. He's giving him very little regard. He's looking for the stoppage. That's all what's on his mind.
Clotty has really planted his feet in the early stages of round number 7, but it's not what got him to the dance.
That's true.
He's changed tack. He is really trying to load up. Separated by referee Shipley. Trying to come over the top of that left shoulder of Josh Clotty, but trying to break his defense. A lot harder than what it seems.
Mundine's got to stick to pure boxing now. Use his height, his strength, his speed, and just stay away from the trouble.
Very hard to come back from the punishment that he's already taken, Ted.
True. I agree, Barry.
One, lad, step, stop, don't punch. Let's go.
Mundine cut over the eye and wears another one.
And he's not taking these punches very well.
And he's retreating. Oh, look at this from Anthony Mundine. Fighting for his professional survival.
He certainly is, and you've got to give him credit. He's coming back, putting good combos together.
I mean, he's been hurt bad to be fighting. And giving back what he's given now is good testimony to the fact that he wants to really win this.
Oh, he really wants it badly, but oh, look, he's just been outgunned by the Ghanaian.
Yeah. Corner's looking a little bit worried there.
So powerful, Josh Clotty, accurate and so busy.
And am I wrong in saying, guys, this is probably what we expected from Shane Mosley?
Yes.
Yeah. There's Mundine on the balls of his feet. That's throwing hard. More punches, but then getting rocked by the sole shot of Clotty. Clotty slipped on the sponsorship signage. Travelling across the ring and headhunting again, Josh Clotty. He's getting through the defences of Anthony easier than we've seen before.
For sure. He's really found holds in Anthony Mundine's defence.
Tape.
He's a lace loose on
the glove. The tape fixed on Anthony Mundine's glove. And strand was pulled off.
Whoa.
Last couple of seconds of the round. It was about reassessing. It was about regathering for Anthony Mundine. A huge 3 minutes for the man. He is still standing.
did well to get through that round.
Definitely.
Round seven gone.
Oh, you left.
Continue doing what you're doing. Making you hot air. No more knockdowns, eh? We need these rounds now. Yeah. Every round now, from now on.
Water.
There's a few now in the corner of Anthony Mundine, all offering advice. This is what we saw in the last round. Mm.
Mundine fought actually very well in the last round. I'm surprised. Great testament to his will to actually come back and after being hurt viciously in the round previously.
Undoubtedly. He's showing incredible fortitude and heart here, Anthony, the man Mundine.
Round number eight, Josh Cloddy is standing in his corner, ready to go. Anthony Mundine to his feet, and we are back into it. It is Cloddy's fight at this point in time, you would suggest. A 10-8 round number three, potentially a 10-7 round number six.
It's quite interesting to note that it's taken for Mundine to get a beating for the crowd to actually scream his name. That must be good for him.
Yeah, good point.
Don't put your head down. Let's go.
You can see the banged up left eye of Anthony Mundine. Cloddy launches himself into action again.
Double rips and hooks and a little uppercut there from Cloddy.
He's throwing big shots.
Back against the ropes, and again, this is where Cloddy really throws that big bomb, that right hand. Good shot from Anthony Mundine, and again going around the defences of Josh Cloddy.
Good work. Great combo.
But Cloddy doesn't look in danger at all.
No, he's relentless. He's just so tough.
Right hand from Cloddy. Mundine really struggling in terms of finding space. Every time he thinks he's found some, Josh Cloddy, he ruins the plan. Body shot from Cloddy. You can hear that echo around Newcastle.
Oh,
and Mundine is taking big shots. He is unsteady.
This is
his future uncertain.
Six. Seven. Eight. All right. Hands up.
His face now a bloody mess. Literally, Anthony Mundine is going to need to produce something extra special.
It's going to be very difficult from here.
Yep.
He has to stop Josh Cloddy.
He does. He's showing a lot of heart, but Cloddy doesn't even look like he's been tainted at all by any shot that's been thrown at him.
No, he is so tough and so relentless.
And smiling now.
Oh, Mundine ripping to the body.
It must be disheartening when Cloddy just comes back.
And Cloddy does not so much as flinch.
Didn't bat an eyelid.
Yep. Oh, he took another right hand there.
Another big right hand.
He's wobbling. He's hurt. He's hurt. Mundine, there's 10 seconds to go.
You'll see the round out.
Don't punch.
Are we seeing the curtain fall on the career of Anthony Mundine? There are four rounds remaining. And shock fans say, not yet.
Chop, you alright?
As always, Joshua Cloddy relentless as we look over the eighth round. A left hook there.
Double left hook.
Yep. He looked hurt and he looked a little tired.
Second one was a beauty.
Top of the head.
honestly, it's getting to the stage where the corner are going to have to think about stopping the fight. I really believe that. How much punishment can he take?
Barry. I tend to think you may well be on the mark there. He still appears, Anthony's got his legs underneath him. It appears his eyes are clear.
Yep.
Maybe the corner's given him the benefit of the doubt here, but four times down, once in the third, twice in the sixth, once in the eighth.
Exactly. And it would be different if he had hurt Clotty back, but he hasn't even hurt, harmed him at all.
No, he'd have to win by a knockout from here.
There is no alternative. He has got to knock out Joshua Clotty.
I mean, Clotty's just relentless. Good body shot.
Body shot from Clotty. Over the top, looking for that left hook again, Josh Clotty. His arms, gloves, elbows, shoulders, heads, everything is being thrown center ring.
Exactly. And Clotty just looks like he's getting stronger and faster.
Mundine trying to get through the defense with a combination of speed and power, but the gloves of Clotty remain strong.
They do.
I'm surprised how well Mundine is actually boxing to say how hurt he's been.
You know, Cotty's defence has been virtually impenetrable. He just walks up and even when Mundine does get through, nothing seems to happen.
Agreed. Iron chin.
And yet Anthony Mundine still looks to push the fight, despite being down four times.
Now he's showing incredible heart and valour. And skill as well, but he's in against a relentless terrier tonight.
Listen.
Good description. And throughout this contest, you're just always waiting for something to happen to Mundine, like Clotty. You know, it's almost guaranteed nothing's going to happen to him. He hasn't been harmed at all throughout this fight.
Yep.
Very solid for a small champion. Very solid.
Clotty wants one last run at the big boys as he comes in again on Anthony Mundine. Back to the ropes, back against it.
Both of yous are doing it, let's go. Clean fight.
The referee's really earning his money on this one.
Powerful punch again to the body. So powerful.
Don't punch, break.
So poised.
Inside 30, round 9.
It will leave 9 minutes for Anthony Mundine to stop Josh Clotty. Clotty has different ideas. He wants to stop the hometown boy.
Over there, mate. Tape! Get it right.
We have a tape issue. Not for the first time, won't be the last time.
Unbelievable. It's doing him no favours either, Josh Clotty.
It's pretty much the end of the round anyway.
It is.
Anthony Mundine just looked down at a friend sitting at ringside. Raised his eyebrows, shook his head as if to say, what do I have to hit this kid with to get him out of here?
Yeah, you're not wrong. I certainly feel for him.
Clotty's corner just advising him, keep up the pressure. He's not liking the pressure, and Mundine is showing that receiving these punches is not going well. He's got to get off the ropes here, as you see Clotty put on extra pressure like he's been doing the whole fight.
For sure. He's committing suicide on the ropes with this bloke.
It's not a good place to be.
But he can't keep him at bay.
Something has to change, and awfully quickly for Anthony Mundine. Three ringside judges watching on. Have they scored it? Now you've scored it at home. Pat O'Connor, Justin Kennedy, Alex Fraser.
keep your head up too.
I think Mundine's only saving grace here is to go the distance. I mean, massive respect if he manages to go the distance. He's been hurt very bad.
Look at that. Yeah. Unbelievable from Mundine.
So, and again, we've got a tape issue for Josh Clottie.
Ridiculous.
Time.
What's wrong with these guys in the corner? They're costing their own fighter.
Right. Next, hey, listen, next one's 1 point. No. Next one's 1 point. Get it right.
I don't know if you can take a point off a corner for...
I've never heard of it before.
It wouldn't make a difference anyway.
No.
No. Yeah. But it's, yeah, I'm sure you can't do that. It's not his fault.
Box.
And we fight on. 225 left in round number 10. Body again closing in. Mundine striking from his heels, striking from the ropes.
Stop! Same punch, same punch. Let's go.
Body trying to rip into the body again.
Vicious rips, and again.
This performance is made up for all the suspect performance Mundine's had. I mean, this is a fantastic fight.
He's
shown a lot of heart, a lot of tenacity. He's done well to be in the ring at this point.
The head gets rocked back again by an uppercut from Clottie. Right. Mundine to the body. Takes a deep breath. Muscles up and starts throwing again.
Unfortunately, Clott is not phased.
Stop.
A welterweight walking, a natural welterweight, should I say, walking through the punches of a powerful middle.
Yep.
It shows how tough Josh Clottie is. True. It's not a reflection on Anthony's power at all.
We've seen Anthony knock a lot of people out in his day.
Oh, absolutely. Mundine here.
What heart.
He knows what the job is. And you don't get to this level without having the big ticker.
True.
Knowing when to use it and when to extend it. Oh. Mundine is down for the fifth time. And the man is silenced.
That's it.
Corner's got to look closely.
I can't believe he jumped up. It looked like it was over then.
Fifth time with 20 seconds remaining in the round. Is the corner...
Yeah, the corner's got to look closely. He's hurt real bad.
Slumps over the ropes.
Box.
10 seconds to go at the end of round 10.
He's going to be saved by the bell here, perhaps.
The corner have to stop it in the corner after this round, I believe. He's just going to get hurt.
We're going to go into the corner with Anthony Mundine, his father, Tony.
He's hurt real bad.
Yeah, water, water, water! You're not going to get enough points. I'm going to let you get hurt, mate. No way. Hey, you want to come back?
Ferocity coming out of the corner, desperation, and that left hook is why. I mean, Joshua Clottie put him down, legitimate left hook. And we thought Mundine was going to stay down for that, but he did well to jump up.
Let's go.
Vicious, vicious left hook.
Spot on the point, spot on the chin.
It was.
We'll talk about heart and guts, but, you know, I mean, when do you seriously consider...
Yeah. That it was considered in the corner and it was Anthony that said no. The ones that care about Anthony in the corner said it's time to call it. He's ahead on points, he is going to win this.
Look at
we
this.
We don't want you to get hurt.
Unbelievable from Anthony Mundine. What heart. Look, Andy, I agree with you totally. But what guts and heart. He just come out throwing bombs.
Clotty again launching himself into business.
Looking for the kill.
dropped five times in the fight.
And dropped heavily, Andy, every single time.
That last one looked like it was all over.
None of these have been flash knockdowns. They've been legitimate, solid punches. Mundine's done well to get up and continue.
Mundine tagged again.
And with a vicious right hand.
He's being stalked by Joshua Cloddy.
Break out. Launching himself is Mundine. Round 11.
Punch.
Halfway through.
Stop.
It's not about victory anymore. It's about survival. It's about pride for Anthony Mundine.
Very true.
Cloddy edging forward.
If you compare this to the Shane Mosley fight, Clotty's stock has gone right through the roof on this one.
What hard
it certainly
Mundine.
Has. Inactivity of Josh Cloddy gave most in the boxing world the thought that Anthony was going to be too good.
True.
Little wardrobe malfunction.
Tell you what, we've seen it all in this fight.
We sure have.
Mundine moving around to his right.
Hello! Sit back, sit
Hopefully
back.
Close the gap on his right hand and the target Anthony, zone on Josh on. Cloddy.
For 1 round and 30 seconds, Mundine just needs to box and use
come
his
on,
ring
sit
skill.
Back. Listen.
The anticipation that gets you on this. You're looking for something to happen.
And no doubt Anthony's looking more closely than most because he hasn't seen the last five coming. The sheer speed of Josh Cloddy has been
amazing.
It has. Phenomenal. And he's relentless. You know, he's just been on top of Mundine all the time.
As he's in around number 11, just one to come.
I can't believe he's made it here. He really deserves to go the distance now.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Water, boy, water.
We have watched
and
him.
Out.
We have marveled at him.
And final round.
For the best part of 14 years. We've screamed at him, we've laughed with him, we've loved him, we've hated him, but we've all admired him. And Anthony Mundine, what isn't spoken about very regularly is what's on the inside, and he has shown every bit on the inside tonight. Amazing heart, amazing drive.
True.
He has been dropped five times. Still, he stands there. Gloves up, eyes focused, ready to throw.
Still throwing bombs, still throwing fast punches.
Yeah.
But he's just been outgunned.
There is a term in boxing, a puncher's chance. And Anthony will need that puncher's chance. That's what he's fighting on at the moment.
Exactly.
And
he's got to give it his all if he wants to win, or he's got to just stay smart and box if he wants to just win, see the end of this fight. But wow, has he taken some punishment and done well to be here.
Trying to get through, penetrate the defenses of Josh Cloddy. It is Newcastle's Mission Impossible.
It is. Unfortunately, Clotty looks fresh.
Doesn't he? Looks like he'd fight another 12.
He looks totally fresh.
A 36-year-old and a 38-year-old at the top of their games, physically. The venue here in Newcastle, no doubt at many around the country, somewhat silenced.
Come on, let go.
Mondino has 1 minute left in this fight to see if he can hear the bell for the end of this last 12th round.
And just to get to the end of the 12th round is some type of feat.
It is. It sure is. He has to... Oh, he took another left hand.
Come on. Last round.
Took a left hand there. Anthony's still throwing punches inside the final 30 seconds.
What a heart Anthony Mundine has shown. He's still on the attack.
Mundine from the inside.
Look out, look out.
He has lived his professional boxing life very much underneath the spotlight. More times than not, he has shone it on himself. But Anthony Mundine tonight has shown you his heart is as big as any. An amazing performance, but Josh Clotty here tonight, far too good.
Great contest.
Wow.
Nothing but admiration from the Newcastle crowd for that man, Josh Clotty. Nothing but admiration for Anthony Mundine too.
That's for sure.
I concur.
He shakes the head. He is healthy. And that's the most important thing.
Certainly
if he chooses, he can fight another day.
I love you guys.
Agreed. If he chooses.
So keep supporting him. He's a very good fighter. Never break you.
Anyone getting nervous for the judges' scorecards?
No.
No. The fact that Mundine saw the end of the fight is testament.
A thunderous applause here to Josh Clotty. The Aussies have very much appreciated and admired what he has produced tonight. And he, as we said in the last round, he looks like he could fight another 12 right now.
I reckon he could. I really think he could. Have a look at him. He is in some fit condition, Joshua Clotty.
Just speaking to Anthony's mum Lynn, she knows the extended family, Kelly, and the grandsons Tyce, Remy's, and Khan are all watching. They should be awfully proud of.
Yeah, he's had a fantastic career,
Uncle
no
Anthony.
Doubt.
Okay, let's go center ring. Let's go to Benny Damon.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause, firstly, for Joshua Clotty and Anthony Mundine.
I hate fighting you because you're a very nice person. I love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous points decision. Our first judge scored at 116-108. Our second judge scored at 115-109. Our third judge scored at 117-108. All in favour of Joshua Grandmaster Clotty.
Josh Clotty, a winner by unanimous points decision, recapping on the 10 points must system, 116-108, 115-109, 117-108. roughly the same scores. It's the same result. Let's go to Josh. He's with Ben.
Joshua, congratulations on a thoroughly dominant performance. This week, you didn't say much by way of a prediction, but is that what you expected to do tonight?
Well, you see, I know I'm fighting with Modin, and I don't want to reveal my secret to him. If Modin is going to understand me, I have to tell him something. He's a brother to me now. You know, in boxing, if you're fighting super middleweight, and you're coming down middleweight, and you're coming to light middleweight, it's going to be a problem to you. I know it's going to be a bigger guy, but my strong, because I'm a natural one for the 154. So if I hit him, he's going to go down. That's what happened.
So you think that Anthony's made a mistake by trying to cut this weight?
In the interview in the face-off, I don't want to tell you that Mondi is making a big mistake by moving down 154, because it's a natural bigger, super middleweight. You don't need to come to straight to light middleweight. You know, besides that, he's growing old. So you need to go up than coming down. That's why the punches are getting him. But he's a strong guy. He's a very good fighter. I respect him so much.
In terms of your career, though, we haven't seen much of you over the last 4 years. Only two fights in that time, but that was an incredible performance tonight. It'd have to take you back to the big stage. Is that what you want?
Yeah, that's what I want. I told you at the face of that, I want to climb a mountain. And it's going to be a tough in America, because it was very disappointed, my fight with Manny Pacquiao. So everybody write me down. So Mondi giving me the chance to fight with him is a blessing to me, because I'm going to be on his shoulders to go up. I really thank him for the opportunity, and I have used my opportunity. He said one thing at the face of that, I get my chance with Manny Pacquiao, I fail. That's not a fail. That's a boxing. Sometimes you get to the ring, you get a cramp, you get a no day. At the end of the day, you're going to lose. Mondi failed now.
So who do you want next? What name?
Well, I think this is a good win. I'm not saying that my performance is better, because I fought 4 years. This is the third fight. So I think I need a couple of fights to sharpen my everything. So I'm not going to mention him. But I have one thing in mind. My defensive is always going to give me with a problem.
Thank you very much, and congratulations, Joshua Clotty.
Thank you so much.
Let's try and get a word with Anthony. Ben muscling his way in there as the two boxers share a moment.
I'm so sorry about everything.
Great sportsmanship. Let's go to Ben.
Anthony, a very nice moment there with Joshua Clotty telling you that he loves you. But certainly tonight did not go as planned for you. Was there any part of you that, given his extended layoff and his inactivity, thought that perhaps he wasn't going to come at full strength tonight?
Nah, I knew what to expect. I told you I wanted to fight the best. I just got caught early and didn't recover like the way I wanted to. But, you know, all props to Joshua, man. I'm not going to, you know, at the end of the day, he was a better man tonight. And, you know, that's it.
He had to say over there that perhaps you've made a mistake, he thinks, by trying to go down in weight. Perhaps you'd be better served staying up. Do you agree with that in any part now, after what has happened tonight?
Maybe. But I don't know. I felt pretty comfortable at the weight. I had energy. I felt I had power. So, yeah, great defense. I tried to get off my combinations. But like I said, I got caught early. And then... You know, but I showed great resilience and just fight out of it and try to, you know, just hurt him late.
You must be proud that you made it the distance, going down five times, staying up and making it 12 rounds against Joshua Clotty in that sort of form.
Was it that many times? Nah, I don't know. You know, after the second or third, I just thought, you know, I wasn't tight enough. My defense wasn't up to scratch tonight. But like I said, full credit to Joshua. He caught me on the button a few times. But like I said, I finished the fight on my feet. And, you know, at the end of the day, to all you mob out there, you know, at the end of the day, you got to have a go. You got to inspire to be the best. You got to inspire to try and achieve your best. And that's what I've done.
Now, the way you've just spoken in that final answer there, is there any chance that that is the end of the road for you in terms of your boxing career? Or what are you looking to do from here?
I'm not really thinking about that right now. I ought to, you know, relax, take some time off, and think about what I want to do, what me and my team want to do. There's always, you know, Daniel Gill or Daniel Green rematch. But who knows? You know, I'll come down to 54 to try and mix with the best. I fought definitely one of the best fighters out there. And unfortunately, I was doing pretty good in the first round, but on the second or third, I got caught. And, you know, that was the way it was.
You mentioned Daniel Gill and Danny Green there. Obviously, you are one all with Daniel Gill on the scorecards. Danny Green, though, there would also be huge interest in that fight. The problem has always been the weight. Where would you go to for that fight?
I don't know. There's big weight problems, but, I mean, I come down to 54. So it's really nothing, you know, I'm just speaking out loud. But I want to have a look at the tape, see what, do the drawing board, because style make fights, and Joshua, you know, I thought it was a perfect style, but like I said, I got caught early. When you get caught early, you sort of throws you off the game plan, and that's it.
All right, thank you, Anthony, and congratulations on making it the distance tonight.
Thank you very much.
Anthony Munzeen, ladies and gentlemen.
A humble and very classy Anthony Munzeen. Not an excuse to be found. Nothing but admiration for his opponent. But it's time to reflect, Baz.
Yeah, look, you know, incredible effort from Anthony Munzeen to go the 12 rounds after being, you know, down in the second, then down, you know, four more times. I honestly didn't think he'd make it, and there were times I thought the corner probably could have pulled it up, but to his credit, he wanted to continue, and he showed that he made it. He made the distance. He was still punching hard at the end. He's a great athlete, and it's going to be interesting to see what he decides to do from here.
Teddy, inside and outside of the ring, the older we get, the heavier we get, for most of us anyway. Anthony cutting weight, what he was able to achieve was spectacular, but was that ultimately his undoing?
Well, firstly, I mean, very gracious in defeat. I think he was very gracious in defeat physically and emotionally when he did the ring interview with Ben Damon up there. I believe the weight loss will or does have a telltale sign on your body as you get older. I mean, you can make the weight and you can look great, but as you know, Barry, it's not about, you know, your six-pack on the floor while the fat guy's looking over you.
Exactly,
you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's I mean, he did fantastic to finish the fight, but if he had that extra, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 kilos on his body, that could have been the difference to just carry him through.